Tales Gets Trolled, one of the most infamous webcomics of the modern age, and one of my personal favorite pieces of media of all time. Even if you've never read it, you've probably seen one of its numerous legendary panels before, possibly used as a reaction image or meme template. In this video, I want to briefly talk about the history of the comic and why I personally like it so much. Yes, I actually like this comic and I think that it's unironically good, and I will attempt to explain why. On October 10th, 2011, a DeviantArt user by the name LaserBot uploaded the first page of a webcomic entitled Tales Gets Trolled, and over the next week he would complete 21 pages comprising the first chapter. It was a story about, well, Tails getting trolled. At least, that's what it starts off as, but it quickly becomes a much larger story about revenge and warring factions, featuring not only Sonic characters, but a wide variety of characters from different intellectual properties, as well as original creations by LaserBot. Over the next few months, he would produce the first four chapters of the comic. On February 18th, 2012, the comic was discovered by Something Awful user Nunez, who proceeded to share it with the forums. The thread attracted quite a lot of attention. Users were fascinated by it. Many fanworks, photoshops, and edits were created in the ensuing days. There was even a front page article showing off some of the best creations from the thread. Some of my favorites were these wonderful animations by Everdread. On March 25th, a reading of the comic made by Something Awful users was released on the YouTube channel Tales Gets Trolled, which eventually reached over 100,000 views. The videos were voiced by Aramek, who does a really fantastic job, and edited by JFlight, who also went on to make that delightful Tales Gets Trolled music album. These videos helped draw even more attention to the comic. By the way, just for the record, just so nobody gets fucking mad at me, here's your disclaimer. You probably shouldn't read this comic if you're under the age of 18. Without getting into spoilers, let's just say some pretty fucked up shit happens, and there's a lot of bad words. More bad words than my stupid fucking videos, even. So if you're the type of person who gets offended by things, maybe you should just give this one a pass. Nowadays, the preferred method of reading the comic is at talesgetstrolled.org, where it has been graciously compiled and hosted for easy viewing. They even offer a zip file containing the entire series to download. I mean, imagine if society collapses and the internet goes down. You would never be able to read Tales Gets Trolled again unless you downloaded a zip file. So what is it about this series that has inspired so much fan art and drawn so much attention over the years? Trust me, there have been countless amateur Sonic fan comics produced. I mean, truly an ungodly, unfathomable amount. So why the hell do people get so fixated on this one? Why am I making a video about it all these years later? Well, I've always been fascinated by outsider art. I don't want this to be taken the wrong way, so let me just read you the definition directly off Wikipedia. Outsider art is art by self-taught or naive art makers. Typically, those labeled as outsider artists have little or no contact with the mainstream art world or art institutions. In many cases, their work is discovered only after their deaths. Often, outsider art illustrates extreme mental states, unconventional ideas, or elaborate fantasy worlds. The term outsider art was coined by art critic Roger Cardinal in 1972 as an English synonym for art brut, meaning raw art or rough art, a label created by French artist Jean Dubuffet to describe art created outside the boundaries of official culture. With the advent of the internet, there's never been a better time to be interested in this kind of art. It's a veritable golden age for it. Indeed, with its mishmash of copyrighted characters and subject matter that fluctuates between the mundane and incredible violence, it's clear that nothing like Tales Gets Trolled could ever come out of the mainstream. The comic has such a strange mix of unintentional and intentional humor. Sometimes it can be difficult to tell what's supposed to be a joke and what's not. There's some legitimately genius shit in here, like Rob, the guy with no ears who's immune to trolling, or the Troll King being an actual bridge troll, and his son being the meme Trollface. It's worth mentioning that LaserBot has expressed written permission from the creator of the Trollface meme to use it in this comic, by the way. The comic is this strange mix of humor and self-seriousness. Edginess and slapstick coexist mere panels apart. Some people might say this comic suffers from extreme tonal whiplash at times, which I can't deny, but that's part of the charm. It's not like all media must objectively stick to a specific tone. There exists a space for avant-garde works which do not care for the established conventions of tonality. Some people seem to be under the impression that LaserBot is faking it and all his weird typos and stuff are just on purpose or something. Based on his posts on DeviantArt and Facebook, I am 100% positive this is not the case. So why do people think this? Well, like I said, there are some moments of extreme self-awareness in Tales Gets Trolled. He's willing to poke fun at some of the mistakes he's made in the past. Like early on, he drew Tails with three tails, and he made a joke about it later on. Same with Shadow looking like he's knitting and Alex smoking his cigarette backwards, as well as some other things. Basically, he's not above laughing at himself, which I think is confusing to some people who have kind of a black and white mentality. To them, either the comic must be 100% serious or must be some kind of parody. It's actually kind of both. It's not like Laserbot isn't aware of how inherently ridiculous most of the events of the comic are. The comic has a number of quirks, like how he's extremely fastidious about making sure every chapter is 21 pages long no matter what, with only a few notable exceptions. But not only do pages vary wildly in size, but he seems to have extremely little regard for the actual start and end of an issue in terms of pacing. Sometimes they end on a cliffhanger, but often they just sort of end in the middle of a scene for seemingly no reason, only to get picked up again in the next issue. Like, the end of chapter 1 is just one page of Mario and Luigi out of nowhere, and the start of chapter 2 is one panel of Mario's face, and then back to Tails. Abruptly switching between characters is just one of those aspects of the comic that you need to get used to. I can definitely understand why some people tend to prefer the first part. The pacing gets a little bogged down later on by cutting between an excessive number of plot threads, and generally just feels a little bit less focused. I don't really mind it so much, but to some people this seems to be a big issue. They really just want the comic to focus on Tails or something. My advice is don't get too attached to any specific character or situation, just let the comic take you where it wants to. Characters who seem important early on might end up not really doing that much in the long run. The characters who might have seemed unimportant or like one-offs might end up becoming main characters. Even Tails, ostensibly the main character of Tails Gets Trolled, will sometimes disappear for chapters at a time. The name Tails Gets Trolled isn't so much a great description of the comic as a whole, as it is a description of what happens on the first page of the first issue. It's the inciting incident from which this grand tapestry unravels. Every time you think you finally get the comic, what it's like and what it's about, you will have the rug pulled out from under you. And while it undeniably is plenty of shit that seems to come out of nowhere, a surprising amount of it builds off of plot threads and seeds of story planted in the earlier chapters. Sometimes lines of dialogue that seem like inconsequential jokes will come back to affect the story in surprising and significant ways. One of the most surprising parts to me when I first read it was that Laserbot actually has genuine talent for composing fight scenes. In fact, it actually has better fight choreography than most shonen manga I've read. Despite the art style, the fights are generally very understandable. The action is readable and the powers are usually decently explained, sometimes a little over-explained, but for the most part they have good pacing. For the most part. And when there are ass pulls, they're at least usually very entertaining and unexpected powers. One of the most interesting things about this comic to me is how the villains are reactive, not proactive. I don't want to spoil too much, but people who have read it will understand what I mean. Unlike most stories, the heroes are the ones instigating the violence. They're the ones who decided to kill the trolls, they lead the assault on Troll City, etc. For the most part, the trolls are literally just defending themselves. It turns out there's simply no way to deal with a troll. You have to kill them. Look, I'm no artist. I have zero drawing abilities whatsoever. And I'm no art critic either. I can't give constructive criticism or feedback. So I feel like a prick just saying the comic has bad art. But let's be objective here. This was drawn in MS Paint with a mouse. I think it could be agreed upon by most people that this is not what they think of when they consider good art. I know artists have all sorts of these made-up rules like perspective and lighting and composition and anatomy. By most of these kinds of metrics, the art of the comic fails spectacularly. And look, I'm not gonna sit here and try and defend this art as actually secretly good. Unless... Look, I don't know what it is, but I'm not even the first person to point out there's something weirdly expressive about his art. Look at Tails' face in this panel. You can truly, viscerally feel the humiliation he's experiencing. It's oddly captivating at times. But yeah, okay, I'll admit by traditional art standards it's got issues. I mean, even beyond that, the comic is riddled with minor mistakes. Like this amusing instance where he clearly started drawing Sonic in this scene, then realized it was supposed to be Shadow, so he quickly just drew over it. I don't know, there's just something weirdly charming about the whole style of it all. I understand for some people this art is going to be too much of a turnoff for you. All I'll say is I got used to the art surprisingly quickly, and it was fascinating watching his style evolve as the series went on. And you don't necessarily need good art to tell a good story. Something that always stood out to me and still brings me untold amounts of joy to this day is the utterly insane text in this comic. The way he uses little arrows, the way the font and text size will seemingly change randomly, sometimes mid-word. the way he clearly puts in the text boxes before writing the dialogue, meaning they're oftentimes either way too big with a bunch of unused space or way too small with words stretching outside the box. It's utterly fascinating. And the spelling, dear God, the spelling. Look at this fucking sentence. It is was not a quintessence us meeting today. That's literally the funniest possible way you could misspell it was not a coincidence us meeting today. And the entire comic is just full of shit like this, every page. I know it sounds like I'm making fun of him or just being really hard on him about this, but I'm being 100% serious. I love this shit, and it makes the comic way better and more enjoyable for me. Look, some people just aren't that good at spelling things, it's not a big deal. He was homeschooled or whatever, so maybe he just never had spelling drilled into him the way us public school drones did. Your ability to spell words is not indicative of your intelligence beyond your ability to memorize a bunch of different letter combinations. I just want to make it perfectly clear I'm not insulting him or calling him stupid or anything like that. I just want to mention the fact that comic is filled to the brim with typographical errors, many of which I find very, very amusing. Even if I could magically fix every typo and weird text box and Tails Gets Trolled, I wouldn't. They give the comic character, and only occasionally do they actually impact your ability to understand a scene. I know by now some people are probably rolling their eyes at how I'm pointing out all these objective flaws, like the art and the spelling, and saying, oh no, you don't understand, that's why I like it. Like, if bad art and spelling really made a comic good, then why don't I just like every webcomic on DeviantArt, right? Well, there's just honestly something special about Tails Gets Trolled. It feels utterly unique. No one on Earth has a brain that works the same way LaserBots does. He got me invested in this weird story that only he's capable of telling. So like I said earlier, if you're even remotely interested in this series, I would strongly recommend by starting with the videos voiced by Aramek. They're currently all compiled and hosted on the YouTube channel Ultimate Tales Gets Trolled, linked in the description of course. He does a truly incredible job, and to me these will always be the definitive voices of the characters. Unfortunately, he only completed the first 7 chapters and doesn't seem interested in continuing, so after that you're just gonna have to read it for yourself. But they should be enough to get you hooked. I remember when I first watched these videos, I thought he was so good he could be a professional voice actor. Which makes sense because he is a professional voice actor, apparently. For example, he's the voice of the main character in this game, Stick It to the Man. So while I would love to demand he continues giving us free, professional-grade voice acting, there's no point bothering someone who doesn't want to do something. We should really be grateful for the chapters he did decide to voice, because like I said, they are absolute works of art. However, this has left the series in a somewhat awkward position where he did such a good job nobody else has even attempted to do a complete reading of the series on the same scale. There are at least 2 animated series that have started, although neither has made much progress and I don't really have much faith in either one covering the entire series. A few people have done amateur read-throughs of the first few chapters on stream, but I don't think anyone has posted themselves reading the entire thing. And even then, there's a difference between reading something on stream in one take and actually sitting down and doing multiple takes with the different voices and cutting out mistakes, editing it to a video with a comic, etc, etc. It would take a lot of work. If you were to search Tails Gets Trolled on YouTube right now, the first result would be Ben Saint's Tails Gets Trolled 101 lecture. This is a competent summary of the events of the series, and it was a video I personally really enjoyed watching, as you get to see a bunch of people's reaction to the crazy events of the plot. One of the most magical things about Tails Gets Trolled is just seeing new people's reactions to it. Something about the comic is just like a mind virus that makes you want to infect other people with knowledge of it. And there are a number of plot twists and events which always get a great rise out of people. However, despite all that, and despite the fact it's a 101 style university lecture ostensibly aimed at newcomers to the series, I would highly recommend against watching this video if you haven't read the comic, for the very simple reason that all the twists and turns he describes to you are infinitely more enjoyable and satisfying if you simply read the actual comic yourself instead of listening to someone just to summarize the whole thing for you. Again, there's nothing wrong with the video in and of itself, and if you're absolutely positive you will never read the comic but are still willing to watch a 1.5 hour long video to know what happens, then sure, go ahead. But otherwise I say read the comic first and then watch the video for the reactions. I mean, if someone made a long ass video explaining the whole plot of Berserk, like yeah, that would be a pretty entertaining story to someone unfamiliar with it, but it would just be better to read the manga, right? On the other hand, his Sonichu 101 lecture is also a very good video, but I would say this is a great entry point if you're interested in Sonichu and that whole saga. If you just try to read the Sonichu comic with no context into Chris Chan's life, it would be genuinely nigh incomprehensible. To put it more bluntly, Sonichu the comic legitimately does not make sense on its own. You really need additional information about the author's life to even understand what the hell is going on most of the time, which this video adequately provides. Which brings me to another point of contention I have. The comparisons between Sonic 2 and Tails gets trolled, or specifically how people will just instantly lump them in together like they're the same thing. Like I said, Sonic 2 really functions more like a lens to view and interpret the author's life, whereas Tails Gets Trolled is a legitimately entertaining, self-contained story that stands on its own merits and requires no outside knowledge to understand, relatively speaking. I mean, I guess it helps to know some of the original properties that most of these copyrighted characters come from, but it's not strictly necessary. Their characterization doesn't always exactly match up with their canon interpretations anyways. I say this with complete and utter sincerity, the Tails Gets Trolled interpretation of Silver is by far my favorite version of the character. Apart from a few handful of moments which I'll discuss later on, you don't really need to know anything about Laserbot to actually understand the comic. In fact, part of the enjoyment of Tails Gets Trolled is how your understanding of Laserbot forms over the course of reading the comic. Like, it's pretty easy to infer that he gets into smoking weed when the characters stop to have a weed party that spans across multiple chapters. Any attempt to delineate the comic into set arcs will be somewhat contentious. There really are not many clear starting and ending points, so I admit these boundaries are somewhat arbitrary. But my basic attempt to break down the series would look something like this, although I'd be happy to hear your own take on it. Maybe we could come to some kind of consensus in the comments. For reasons I already explained, I'm not going to be doing an exhaustive plot summary of the series, even though I do kind of want to. It would be really fun to just talk about every single thing that happens in the comic, but that would kind of defeat the purpose of making this video, trying to get you to read it for yourself. Maybe at some point I'll stream myself reading through it, so if you really want to know my thoughts on every single panel, and trust me, I have them, you'll have to wait for that. I love the entire comic, but I do have a special fondness for those first four chapters. They were produced before Laserbot was discovered by something awful. He was basically just making those chapters for himself. I don't know what kind of viewership he was getting on DeviantArt, but it had to have been pretty small. Once he was made aware of his newfound popularity, he couldn't help but adjust the comic based on the feedback he was getting. He seemed apprehensive about some of the attention his comic was getting at first, specifically the people bashing it and making fun of it, but he seemed to appreciate his new audience, and even early on there were people professing their enjoyment and admiration for the comic. Still, it's only natural that he becomes somewhat self-conscious about this massive increase in viewership. At multiple points in the comic, he would occasionally reference the general feedback he was getting from the Something Awful thread, and he would occasionally insert little Something Awful references in the comic. Because the comic was coming out on a page-by-page basis, people would sometimes get impatient with what they considered to be pointless diversions. In particular, during the prolonged fight between two of his original characters, Gary and Damaro, he got a lot of negative feedback from people who just wanted him to get back to Tails and the silly troll shenanigans, and he made note of this in the comic. He would often mock these complaints as those of stupid and impatient fans. One topic he was particularly sensitive about was comparisons of his comic to Dragon Ball Z. I made the following post on Facebook about the matter. Hello. I like all you, my fans, but there's one thing that's getting on my nerves and confusing me a bit. Why is everyone comparing my comic to Dragon Ball Z? This comic is nothing like DBZ. My Tails Gets Trolled comic is nothing like DBZ. None of it really. How is this like DBZ, I ask? The fights are far from DBZ fights. So I don't get how this is anything related to DBZ besides the little things I use from DBZ like the Dragon Balls, but that's the only thing that's DBZ related to this comic. I don't get how you guys think it's like DBZ. I mean, the story and the fighting on Tails Gets Trolled DGT is nothing like DBZ. This also comes up at multiple points in the comic itself, including multiple long, drawn-out parody sequences made in order to illustrate the difference between his style of fight scenes and DBZ's. And you know what? To his credit, he's actually right. The fights in DBZ are much more about power levels, transformations, and energy blasts. The fights in Tails Gets Trolled are more like Hunter x Hunter or JoJo in that they're fights between characters with very specific powers which have usually been explained in detail. On August 4th, 2012, Laserbot's DeviantArt account was hacked, and he began posting the comic under a new account. He actually referenced this incident in Tails Gets Trolled by writing the hacker into the comic as a fat, disgusting slob, only for him to immediately get brutally murdered. Who the hell is that? Asks Tom. I don't know. He's forgotten. No one will remember him, stoically replies Sylvester. I'll never forget this hilarious message Laserbot left the hacker, simultaneously begging for his account back while also threatening him like an anime villain. Admit defeat already. You must know by now there is no ending here that you win. You must have realized it by now. You can send me a note with your new password for it, or you can continue to fail over and over again. You was destined to lose this, so why don't you save yourself the trouble and time and pick the right choice? You do know the easy way out is to retreat and find a foe you can actually go against. It would be lucky and a shocker if you didn't try to mess with people, but make your choice. You know that you lost, so why not stop this embarrassment already? What do you say? Or would you like some more of that embarrassment? Your fate was to lose, and you should realize that. Everyone sees through your tricks and deceit, so stop fooling yourself. Stop being in denial. It's over. You ran out of tricks, and me and the rest of us still have many more tricks up our sleeves. Make this easy on yourself. There was also a period of time where he was clearly getting a little tired of just being known for this comic, and he seemed a little sensitive to the Sonichu comparisons. Don't get me wrong, he is ultimately proud of his work, but there was definitely a time where he seemed like he just wanted to work on other projects. He was still actively posting things to his DeviantArt, but just not working on the comic as much. Like every great manga, the bulk of it was published in one mostly uninterrupted block at the start, and then it's been a slow drip feed of content between interminable hiatuses ever since. Most of the comic was drawn from late 2011 through 2012. During this time, he was putting out roughly a page a day. Work continued through 2013, but at a slower pace, with chapters 15 through 18 coming out that year. Chapters 19 through 21 were released over the course of the next 2 years, with the comic going on hiatus until chapter 22 was released in 2017. Since then, no new pages have been released by LaserBot. It wasn't all by choice. He had long stretches where real-life issues were preventing him from working on the comic. For a while he didn't have a mouse, then he didn't have internet, then he didn't have a computer, and he was homeless for a brief period. There was always something that seemed to prevent him from being able to work on the comic. He has stated at various points in time that he wants the final product to be about 60 chapters long. Originally he said 100 chapters before revising his estimate down, although he's also said he's barely told a quarter of the story he wants to, so who knows how long the comic will end up being or how long it'll take to finish. The confrontation between Coyote and Damaro began on October 8th, 2012 and is still going to this day. It's worth mentioning that at some point LaserBot's brother Embergram became involved in working on the series, eventually being listed as a co-writer. On August 19th, 2017, LaserBot posted the last page of Chapter 22, and it would be the final page he would produce for Tales Gets Trolled. That is, for the original Tales Gets Trolled, because he announced a new project, Tales Gets Trolled Polished. He stated his intention was to start all over from the very first issue with a remastered version of the comic. This new version did more than just improve the art, it also endeavored to fix the spelling and grammatical mistakes, and new scenes would be added to the comic, and some old scenes were redrawn to include new characters. He stated that he would eventually continue the story from the cliffhanger at the end of Chapter 22, once he had gone through and polished the entire comic up to that point. Needless to say, fans were not happy about this decision. Nevertheless, LaserBot was adamant about this new project. He insisted to be able to quickly remaster the entire series and get back to where he left off before too long. He even went so far as to call this the real Tales Gets Trolled and said the original series was more akin to a rough draft. Like I said, I'm no art critic, but these so-called improvements and attempts at adding shading or whatever just kind of look like shit to me. I really see no point in going back and muddying up these simple drawings with unnecessary detail. And in addition, he also reformatted the comic with this bizarre panel layout, ugly backgrounds, and added a please donate banner on every page. As I explained before, I personally found a lot of enjoyment in the bizarre spelling mistakes, so going through the comic to fix them doesn't really do anything to improve the comic for me, but it is a change I can understand. However, the issues with Polished are far deeper than just the new art, they're structural. One of the best things about the early chapters of Tales Gets Trolled is they moved along at a brisk pace, major events were happening pretty regularly. This new version is absolutely brimming with pointless filler and unnecessary attempts at humor instead of just letting it come organically from the situations and characters. I wholeheartedly believe the charm of Tales Gets Trolled largely comes from its progression, how the early chapters were so nonchalant and didn't give a shit about narrative or dramatic pacing, only to evolve into a story with higher stakes and a more convoluted plot that weaves events from the earlier chapters into later storylines and gives them new meaning in hindsight. Tales Gets Trolled Polished decides it wants to be the true, chronological telling of the story, and it makes it so everything is melodramatic and convoluted from the start. It really sucks the fun and natural flow out of the chapter. Multiple pages dedicated to humanizing the two throwaway trolls from the start who still just get killed off by Shadow, but instead of the scene just being him unexpectedly murdering them and revealing his philosophy of they can't troll you if they're dead, he tries to work in some unnecessary foreshadowing by inserting visions of Eggman, further complicating the scene. The murder is longer, more violent and gruesome, but the scene is also sillier because of the inclusion of this character from the movie Ants. Polish also ran some of the jokes into the ground. In the original, Vector calling Espio the Pink Guy was hilarious since they're both members of the Chaotix. You'd expect Vector to know the name of his close friend. It's literally just one line, but it was a funny moment. When Polish literally everyone calls him it, it's like his new nickname, and he makes a big deal out of it, like, come on guys, you should know my name. But the biggest sin, in my opinion, is Laserbot just taking the Sonic and Amy flashback scene from Chapter 19 and pasting it directly into Chapter 1. Like, that flashback was originally built up with several chapters leading into it, and originally the major impact of this scene was how it recontextualizes a seemingly throwaway line from the first chapter. Now it just feels completely pointless. It's just tossed in because that's when it chronologically happens. He also even dropped hints like he wanted to change some plot details in Polished, including changing some very important aspects of the original. Like, I think he was going to not kill off a certain character whose death I think was really, really important in the original comic. In my entire life, I don't think I've ever seen such a unanimous agreement from a fanbase. This new comic is shit, please stop making it and just continue with Chapter 23. Which left Laserbot feeling a little miffed because he was absolutely insistent that Tails Gets Trolled Polished was the way to go. This was his artistic vision and he was sticking to it. This led to his newly formed Patreon immediately tanking and he would soon cease production on Polished after only 32 pages. The notion that Tails Gets Trolled Polished was just going to catch up to the main comic in a timely fashion was just clearly not true, but when people tried to explain this to Laserbot he got very defensive. Even beyond the fact that obviously a remaster project like this is just going to take a lot of time, the sheer amount of added content to Tails Gets Trolled Polished was essentially making a new comic at the same time as remastering the old one. Polished only made 32 pages in, but in terms of main plot, Shadow and Knuckles aren't even finished burying the Fat Troll, which is done by page 10 in the original, so it's moving at less than one-third of the pace. It was clear this was just a doomed endeavor from the start. Now that it's been cancelled, there's really no reason for me to be so hard on it, and I'm sure Laserbot is still sick and tired of hearing people bitch about it. But goddamn man, it was just such a bad idea. To this day, it still impresses me how misguided it was. You know, this whole starting over from the beginning to make a more polished version reminds me of another Sonic Mario crossover fan work, Super Mario Bros. Z. It also underwent an extended hiatus and eventually came back with a remastered version, although in this case the remastered version is actually pretty good. I still feel like it's going to take years before he can catch up to the point where the original went on hiatus, but oh well. If you ask me, he should just pick up where he left off, but apparently once these creative types get in their head they're going to remaster the whole thing, it's hard to talk them out of it. One of the stranger things that happened during this time was an attempt to make a censored version, which changed the dialogue to be more tame and family-friendly, and changed some of the artwork as well. This was a very short-lived project and only got a few pages in, probably because they realized there's not really a good way to show a censored version of all the violent murder scenes ahead. I mean, this was just a very bizarre and strange idea, but I don't think much time was spent on it, so it's not a big deal, it's just a funny little experiment. Believe it or not, neither Tails Gets Trolled Polished or Censored were what I would consider to be his worst idea in terms of new directions for the comic. No, that announcement would come on March 5th, 2018. In this post, he announced he and his brother were going to take their attention away from Tails Gets Trolled to focus on a new project, but they'd be hosting some Q&A sessions if you had any unanswered questions about the series. It was here he had the idea to split Tails Gets Trolled into two separate projects. One focused on the comedy with all the wacky copyrighted characters called the Troll Slayers, and another focused on the overarching plot and fight sequences, which replaces all of the copyrighted characters with original characters, and this would be called Tails Realm. As far as I know, thankfully this idea never made it out of the planning phase. Tails Gets Trolled is one of the most strange, unique, eclectic mixtures of comedy and drama I've ever seen in my life. Why you would go out of your way to separate these two elements just strikes me as one of the most clear examples of a creator not understanding why their work was popular in the first place. So after all that, some of you might be wondering, what's the current status of the comic? Is it officially cancelled, or finished, or what? Well, after years of being on hiatus, Tails Gets Trolled is finally updating again. A team of dedicated fans got together and they started drawing new pages based on Laserbot's Chapter 23 script, which had been posted to his Patreon a few years back. I like the art team's new style, I mean, it's legitimately good art, it's just the change in styles is definitely a little jarring at first. And part of me will always miss the original Laserbot aesthetic for reasons I already explained, but given the choice between rad new art style and no new pages ever, I'll just take the new art style. They're slowly but surely making progress with a new page every few weeks. They have a Discord you can join and Laserbot occasionally checks in on his phone, since apparently he doesn't have access to a computer at the moment or something, I don't know. But this project has his blessing and is an official continuation. I believe he's committed to writing more script once they finish drawing this chapter too, but I guess we'll just have to wait and see. You can inquire about joining the team on the Discord, but apparently they've had some trouble with Flake, so please only inquire if you're a serious, cool guy. I might have seemed a little harsh on Laserbot in the back half of this video. The truth is, I have a ton of respect for him as a creator. I just want to see him succeed and create the comic I know he's capable of creating. At the end of the day, he's the guy who made Tails Gets Trolled, and I'm the guy talking about it. That says it all right there, doesn't it? I'm just giving my perspective as a fan. Believe me, there's nothing I'd like to see more than for the comic to get finished within my lifetime. I know it sounds trite, but I feel like I've barely scratched the surface of the tip of the iceberg when it comes to explaining why I like this comic. This video might not have convinced you that it's good, but I hope it at least intrigued you into maybe considering checking it out for yourself. Maybe I'll do an in-depth plot analysis one day if people are into it. If you want to see it finished, please consider donating to his Patreon, Zagar's Lab. Yes, that's what it's called. Or donate directly via PayPal. I'd like to give a super special thanks to the TalesGetsTrolled.org admin, Puke Fukum, Jazzflight, Aramek, Aubrey, Nunez, and anyone who's ever dumped the comic on V, and of course, Laserbot himself. I'll leave you with this old comment left on his DeviantArt by a fan. Laserbot, I want you to know that I had been suffering from severe depression and was strongly contemplating suicide until I found your comic. Now that I've found it, my life has a completely new outlook, so I just wanted to thank you for this great joy you've brought to me. Thanks you. The suicide part was a little freaky, but thanks.